So if I now run this linear regression command, it works without errors. Yeah, I don't need a data argument here because I have the values of x and y directly in a specified in the vector. So this time no error. But let's take a look at the result. So I find an estimate of beta hat 0, so for the constant, or it's also called intercept, which is 99.89, so it's close to the 100, but not exactly the 100. And for our slope, the estimate for beta 1 hat, the estimate in front of the x, is 1.081, and the true value is 1. So it's again close, but not the same value. Then I could repeat this. So I could simulate some new values and run this regression again, and I can do it once more again. And every time we basically get a different estimate for the coefficients and the slope. Interesting, the slope is always bigger than one, but that's just random luck. So now here we have one time a very low slope. So every time I get a different estimator, it's kind of seems to be distributed around these two parameters, beta 0 and beta 1, but they are never exactly the same, and that is due to this random noise generated by this error term u. If we would say u is always 0, and I would run this regression, then I would get a perfect fit. If I have no error term, if the error is always 0, then I perfectly find the two coefficients, but given that I have this noisy error term, my estimates will never actually directly match the true coefficients. What I now want to do is I want to run the simulation a lot of times, maybe 1,000 times, and collect our estimates for beta 1 hat, so the estimated coefficient in front of the x. And there are many ways to do this in R. You could write for loops and whatever, but usually it's helpful to put all your simulation code into a function. So a function will have a name, I call it sim and s, and then I write equal to, and then I just say function, and there we have the normal braces that we can later put some function arguments inside, but won't do this in the moment. Then I have this curly braces, and I put basically all my simulation code inside this curly braces, and to make it look better, I mark it and press tab once, then it's basically set off here to the right. So that's how you would write a nice function, and I can run this code, and then I have this function specified. Here we also see it in the environment, sim and est, and now I can call this function by just calling sim and est and this braces, and then it basically it runs the simulation and returns me my coefficients. I can also say that it shall only return the estimated coefficient for x. So coef returns the coefficients as a vector. And then if I take the second element of this vector, it's a coefficient in front of the x. So that would be basically be the beta 1 hat. So I say return beta 1 hat. You can also write the argument return. That means that will be the value that the function returns when you call it. Otherwise, it just returns the last value that was computed when you call the function. So I'm going relatively quickly through this function program because it's, at least at this point, not yet something you should be able to do yourself. Maybe later we will develop it a bit further in the course. I've not yet decided. If I write it now like this and call the function again, it will return basically just this estimate for the coefficient in front of x. And so I can now call it a lot of times. And every time I get a different estimate because I have a different realization of our random variables, in particular the error term u is different every time. Now there's an R function called replicate, and it allows us to conveniently call a function many times. So the first argument is n, tells us how often we want to call the function. Let's call it 10 times, and then we have a function call or any expression we want to evaluate. So that's just sim and s, and if I call it, it basically returns the values of 10 times having called this function. So we have basically 10 realizations of our estimator beta 1 hat. And maybe let's replicate it 10,000 times. I don't know how long it takes. Maybe that's a bit too long. 1,000 times, and let's store the result in the vector beta 1 hat. And I run it. So it takes a little while. And then I have these results, beta 1 hat. I can show it. So we have now basically 1,000 realizations of our estimator beta 1 hat. And we can analyze this graphically. So the easiest way, even so it doesn't look the nicest, would be a histogram of beta 1 hat. And we can also set some fill color. Let's say it shall be red. And then we see here now a histogram of beta 1 hat. And this may actually look roughly normally distributed. Yeah, so it seems as if the average value is around 1. We can check this if we take the mean of beta 1 hat. That's roughly 1. So it's actually close to the true coefficient beta 1. And it also has a standard deviation. And this will actually be the standard error, the standard deviation of our estimate, so it's 0.23. Okay, and so the key idea, that you shall get is that actually an estimator can be considered as a random variable, and that's what a lot of econometrics is about. So we have this regression model. And in the end, our coefficients, beta 0 hat and beta 1 hat, are functions of the realization of this error term. And also, they also depend on the x and the true coefficients. But the error term is a random variable. And in this sense, our estimator, beta 1 hat, is a random variable. And here we have used the simulations where we basically 1,000 times draw new realizations of u and x and computed beta 1 hat to basically approximate this distribution of this random variable. And as a random variable, it has an expected value. Our simulation suggested that this is actually here very close to the true value of beta 1 equal to 1, and it has a standard deviation. And the standard deviation is called the standard error. And maybe let's make a short quiz. What do you think happens if with the standard error, if I increase the number of observations, if instead of only 20, I would take, let's say 80 observations, four times as many observations, what will happen with the distribution of our estimator, in particular, what will happen with its standard error?